Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Your subscription and likes are always motivating us. So please comment in the section about the video so we can able to improve the video content as well as the video quality. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about fundamentals of pathology. I am going to cover the losses caused by plant diseases as well as the causes of plant diseases. So while seeing plant pathology, I have already given the definition, but I am once going to remember you. It is said to be known as the branch of biological science which usually deals with the cause, etiology as well as the resulting losses and control of plant diseases in the crop cultivation areas. So while seeing about the causes of plant diseases, they are said to be broadly classified into two causes. The first one is insect, which is a biotic causes, which is mainly caused by insects as well as the pathogens, and the abiotic causes, so which is composed of nutrient deficiencies, of excess salinity, herbicide damage, low on high temperature and climatic factors. So some of the reasonable example for abiotic causes are air pollution, which used to cause weather flock of tobacco, as well as the herbicide, which is 2,4-D in cotton, causes some damages, as well as the brick clints, so black tip of mango, sun scale, shaded plants used to have rotting of the fruits, and poor aeration used to leads to the hot rot of potato. So while we are going to see about the group of pathogens which used to attacks or affects the plant diseases are protozoa, fungi, bacteria, candidatus, phytoplasma, fatidius, vascular bacteria, spiroplasma, virus, viroids, algae, venerogamic parasite, abiotic disorders. So I have given some of the pictures of viroids, bacterium, as well as cell walls which used to come have the fungus and protozoan pictures which used to affect the plant cells. So it is said to be also known as the schematic diagram of shapes and sizes of certain plant pathogens in relation to the plant cells. So first we are going to see the classification of fungi. So it was given by Ainsworth in Bibitzi's Dictionary of Fungi at the 10th edition. So that while seeing them, they used to comes under the phylum Mycota, and subphylum Mycotina, classes Mycetes, and subclass Mycetidae, order Alles, and family Aces. So genus and species are said to be different for each and every organisms. So while seeing the classification of fungi, they use it to classify it into three superkingdoms, or else you can able to call it as domains, which are bacteria, archaea, and eukarya. In those domains, in domain eukarya, it is even classified into five kingdoms. So they are protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantae, as well as animalia. So first we are going to see about the kingdom protozoa, which used to comes under the phylum Plasmidium Mycota, and the class is Plasmidophora Mycetes, and order Plasmidoporales, and family Plasmidoporaceae. While seeing about the general characteristics of protozoa, they are said to be known as the naked unicellular cells, which used to have plasmodial or ambodial somatic base. See, they used to also have lack of hypae and cell wall, and the asexual spores are said to be known as the motile zoospores, as well as they are biflagellate in nature. And the sexual reproduction of protozoa are said to be the fusion of motile isogametes, and they are also known as the necrotrophic endoparasites. And the diseases caused by the protozoan are the major diseases known to us are clubroot of cabbage, potato, powdery scab of potato, as well as the polymyxia gramnis, which is also known as the vector of viral disease in cereals. So these are the images of clubroot of cabbage. And after that we are going to see about the kingdom Chromista, which used to comes under the phylum Oomycota, and the classes Oomycetes. So in Oomycetes there are said to be three different orders, which is Pithiales, Peranosporales, and Sclerosporales. So it used to have different families, we can be able to see them one by one. So after that we are going to see about the classification of fungi, which is comes under the kingdom of third. And in fungi they are classified into six phyla. So we can able to classify them as the plant related one as well as the other ones. So in these plant related one, the most three important are Zygomycota, Ascomycota, and Basidiomycota, which are the common pathogenic fungi we are going to study in these lectures. And the other three are microsporidae, chiteridae and glomeromycotidae. So we can able to have a basic knowledge among these three one, and the deeper one we are going to study are zygomycota, ascomycota and basidiomycota. So zygomycota, which is to be known as the zygote fungi, ascomycota, which is a sac fungi, and basidiomycota, which is a club fungi. So first we are going to see about the phylum zygomycota, so which used to have the class of zygomycetes and order Mucorales and the family Mucoraceae, and the example is Mucus rhizopus is an example genera. And while seeing a common division of fungus, so which is said to be known as the heterotrophic organism devoid of chlorophylls, and they also used to have cell wall which are non-motile in nature, and they are reproduced by spores produced by them, and the primary storage product is glycogen, and they are usually filamentous as well as eukaryotic and multicellular in nature. These are the some basic important things we must need to know about the fungus. And after that we are going to see about the general characteristics of bacteria, which are said to be unicellular in nature, microscopic organisms at the dimension of 0.5 to 0.2 micrometers, and prokaryotic in nature. They also lack of chlorophyll and mitochondria. They are reproduced by the binary fission, so which is one of the asexual reproduction methods. It's how bacteria used to reproduce. So it is the structure of bacteria. The components present in bacteria are protoplast, cell wall, nucleoid, flagella, fili, capsule and plasmids. And while seeing the cell and cell membranes, which is said to be surrounded by three membranes, which is gram plus plasmid membrane, which is covered with a thick wall of peptidoglycan, which is used to regulate the exchange of nutrients in each and every organism. So I have given the picture of the cell membranes in this one, which you also used to have gram-positive as well as gram-negative membranes. So while seeing the cell and cell wall and cell membrane, the inner cytoplasmic membrane, which is said to be thicker and denser than cytoplasm, and they are said to be selectively permeable like lipids and protein. And after that we are going to see the central cell wall, which is said to be the shape, gives shape to the bacteria and selectively permeable, and also react to the gram staining. And after the outer slime, which is said to be known as the capsule, also a productive agent in these cell membranes. And after that we are going to study about the nucleus and vacuoles. So nucleoid, which is said to be known as the lac nuclear membrane one, and they are prokaryotic in nature. And while seeing vacuoles, which is said to be seen in young cells and appear like cavity in the protoplasm, and which is used to contain cell sap in the bacteria, and fat and flat globules and spores, which are large or minor globules, which is also known as the reservoir of food material. Those spores and bacillus are said to be found in bacillus bacteria, and they are endospores are said to be present. With adverse environmental condition, they can able to even live in the adverse environmental conditions. So the destruction of such spores are said to be the critical one for most of the species. And the plasmids are said to be known as easy. And after that we are going to see the flagella, which is flagella is said to be known as the organ of locomotion. They are said to be known as the delicate thread-like structure, which is said to be longer than the cells. So you can able to classify the flagella in different organisms. They are the monotrichus, where you can able to see the one flagella at one end, and lophotrichus, where you can able to see the more number of flagella at one end, and apotrichus, where you can, which is said to be known as the biflagellate, which is said to be present at two different ends, and petrichus, where you can able to see multiple number of flagella present in them, and atrichus, which is a different one. And while seeing about the reproduction, they are used to have a binary fission, which used to takes around 15 minutes for the production of new cells. So it is the picture where you can able to see the duplication of chromosome and continuous growth of the cell. And finally they are get to be divided within the period of 15 minutes. And while seeing the shapes of the bacteria, so the shapes are coccus, spherical or ovoid. So micrococcus, diplococcus, streptococcus, staphylococcus and saccharine, like cubes, packets of 8 cells. So there are different shapes which are present in the bacteria, but the most important one is said to be found I have listed in these images, so please go through it. And while seeing that the bacillus which is said to be a rod shaped bacteria. And while seeing about the bacillus, they are classified into three types. So they are the microbacillus, which is a single shaped bacteria, diplobacillus, which used to have two adhering cells, and a streptobacillus, which used to have a chain of more than two cells, and the spirillum, which is spiral or helical forms in these bacillus. And while seeing about the spread and symptoms, so the bacteria is said to be mostly transmitted by water, insects, and other animals. Even humans are said to be the transfer agents. And the symptoms are blights, soft rot, leaf spot, tumors and galls, canker, and boils. So these are the images of the symptoms of the bacteria. So after that, I have also given on an important disease in rice, which is a bacterial leaf blight of rice. So Xanthomonas oryzae, PV oryzae, is a causative organism. And cotton, which used to have angular leaf spot disease, which is also known as the bacterial disease of cotton, or you can able to name it as the bacterial blight of cotton. So these are the images where you can able to see the angular blighting of leaves, as well as the pod rot. And citrus canker, one of the important diseases which used to reduce the quality of the citrus trees, as well as the quantity of production. And potato scab, which is caused by Streptomyces scabies. So they use it to rot the economic part of the plant. And after that, we are going to see the plant virus general characteristics, which are said to be ultra microscopic, which is nanometer in size, which are disease producing entites. And they use it to have no metabolic enzymes present in them, and they contain only one type of nucleic acid, which can either be RNA or DNA type. And they are said to be obligate parasite with various shapes, and they can be able to pass through bacteriological filters present on them. So while seeing about if virus is a living or non-living, so they use it to go for both the living as well as non-living. So in living, they can able to reproduce, as they can able to mutate in the environment. As while seeing about the non-living, they are lack of cellular structure, no enzyme, no respiration, as well as no crystallization are said to be found in the mechanism of virus. So you can able to classify them as both of them. And after that, we are going to see the shapes. So which is rod, ringgit rod, which is TMB, and a flex rod, citrus rhizavirus, and a spherical shape, which is TSWB, and Gemini, which is a two particulate attached in them. So these are the images which we have described about them. And after that, we are going to see about the composition of those virids. So the inner nucleic acid, which is said to be either DNA or RNA molecule. So the outermost thing is said to be the protein coat, as well as in RNA virus, it is said to be a TSWB, as well as TSV, and DNA, which is cauliflower mosaic virus, and virids, which is a virus without a protein coat, are said to be known as virids. And while seeing about the multiplication capacity, also their multiplication procedure, the first virus, which is used to have DNA as well as capsid, which enters into the cell of an uncoating of DNA, so where they can able to replicate or transcription is said to be done, where it can be a viral DNA or also RNA, and the translation process are made, and the capsid protein are said to be produced, and the self assembly of new virus particle and their are said to be exit from the cells, or said to be produced, and they get out of the cells. And while seeing about the transmission process, which is said to be mechanical in TMB, and seeds, which use it to cause leaf crinkle, as well as the vegetative propagative materials like PVY, and the grafting of peach mosaic virus, and vectors, the insect nematodes, mites, and the fungi and dodders. So in these viruses, the transmission process is said to be taken place. So these are some of the insects, and where the in rice to grow virus. So with the vector is nephrotic virescens, and after that in pulses yellow mosaic, the vector is Bemisia tabaci, as well as in bingitop virus. So the vector is Pentlochia nigrovoscens, and these are the images.
as well as in tobacco mosaic virus, nicotino virus, as well as in papaya ring spot. The papaya ring spot virus vector is Aphis coccebi and mice pericier. So they used to show those symptoms which I have described in these images, and as well as the candidate test phytoplasma, which is said to be bound by a three-layer membrane, which is also known as the triple-layer membrane without rigid cell wall. They are said to be highly polymorphic coccoid ring forms as well as fine filamentous. They are said to be very small, unicellular, non-motile, as well as prokaryotic in nature, and they are grown in cell from cell-free media, so they can able to easily pass through any bacteriological filters because they are said to be smaller than the bacterial cells. So these virus can able to pass through any bacteriological filters, and they are also used to be resistant to penicillin as well as the sensitive to tetracycline, and they require sterol for their growth, and they are mainly stained by dyeing stain, which used to show violet blue color. So these are the pleomorphic phytoplasma in seed tissues images and the reaction to dyeing stains. So while seeing about the spread, they are mainly spread through grafting, door and mechanical injuries, as well as in insects they are transported by plant hoppers. So while after that we are going to see about the disease Gengeli pylori. So where the economic pods, or else you can able to say it as the flowers, are said to be converted into green leafy structures, so which makes the plant is said to be sterile, and the main transmission is through plant hoppers. So example of the plant hopper is Oracis albicintus, is one of the plant hopper which is used for the transmission of Gengeli pylori. And after that we are going to see the little leaf of brinjal, where they use it to show the stimulation of axillary buds, and they use it to form a thin small nervous leaves in their economic pod. So they use it to show a bunchy appearance, as well as they makes the plants sterile in nature. And while seeing about the virads, so potato spindle tuber is said to be one of the most example, which is used to be cause disease at least in 15 other crops, so which are said to be caused by virads. So Theodore O. Denier, who is a plant pathologist who used to discover the pathogen, named it as virad, and because it looks like virus but without the protein capsule. So it was happened in 1971. And while seeing about the virad, they used to have a unique class of plant pathogen consisting of small single-strained circular RNA, which is not said to be encapsulated in a protein coat. These are said to be naked RNA molecules which used to cause a serious plant diseases, and the RNA genome of virads are around 246 to 375 nucleotides in their length in comparisons, as well as they are said to be a single-stranded colon circles, and they use it to replicate, which does not depend on the presence of the helper virus present in the cells, and there is no proteins are said to be decoded in virus because they are absence of protein coats in their bodies. And these are the images of potato spindle tubers, avocado subspinach virus, and some of the different viroids. So I have also given the picture of coconut kadang kadang virus diseases in coconut palm, where they are said to be infected in their foreground, and they also use it to display yellowing and stunting, which even reduce their crown growth, and there is no nut formation, where the economic yield is said to be reduced in them, as well as the citrus exocrine virids, which used to have the swallowing of the trunk. After that, we are going to see about the spiroplasma, which is a genus of molluscs, a small group of bacteria which without cell walls. So the while seeing about the spiroplasma, which used to share a simple metabolism, parasitic lifestyle, as well as they used to have a fried egg colony morphology in their nature, and the small genome of other molecules, but they used to have a distinct helical morphology unlike mycoplasma. So it used to have a spiral shape as well as moves in the corkscrew motion. So other things about the spiroplasma are, they are said to be found in gut, hemolymph of the insect, as well as the phloem of the plant. So the pyroplasma are said to be a fastidious organism which used to require a rich culture medium. So they, we can able to grow them in an artificial medium at 30 degrees centigrade, but not as high as at 37 degree centigrade. So a few species of notably Spiroplasma Merriam can able to grow under 37 degrees centigrade, which is to be known as the human body temperature, and also they use it to cause us cataract and neurological damage in sickling mice. So while thinking about what are the disease caused by the Spiroplasma or the Spiroplasma citri and the causative agent of citrus tadpole disease and Spiroplasma kunkeli, which is the causative agent of corn stunt diseases, and so I have given the lecture notes in description. So if you like the video, please comment about our video and join us in the Instagram page, which is in the about of our YouTube channel, and I have also given the link in the lecture notes. So if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to BSE Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.